Centrifugal pump, tutorial question number one. A centrifugal pump is driven by an electric motor at 1450 RPM. Outlet diameter of blade, outlet blade width, and outlet blade angle are 600 mm, 400 mm, and 30 degree respectively. Inlet diameter of blade, inlet blade width, and inlet blade angle are 300 mm, 80 mm and 20 degree respectively. Pressure at suction pipe and delivery are negative 0.5 bar and positive 13.5 bar respectively. Assume that the diameter for suction and delivery pipes is equal. The flow rate inside the pipe is 0.3 meter cube per second. From this information, we need to determine the manometric head HM, the manometric efficiency, and the power required by electric motor if overall efficiency is 78%. From the question, we know that we list all the information like this. So we have RPM here, we have flow rate, and then we could divide the information for outlet. So we have a subscript 2 here, we have a pressure at outlet, angle at outlet, the diameter for outlet, and width for outlet, and then the information for inlet with subscript 1 here is listed like this, and then the relationship between bar and kilopascal is showing like this. And then I hope you remember the location of the blade angle. For example, we have blade here, and then we could say that if this is the tangent line for the inlet at the inlet point, so this is the angle of the blade. And if we have a tangent line at the outlet like this, and this is the blade angle at the outlet. And then from the question, we know that suction pipe and delivery pipe have the same diameter. So the idea from this statement is we know that if the diameter is the same, so the velocity will be the same too. So in the first question, we need to calculate the value of manometer head. So we could calculate this one by using Bernoulli equation, because we assume that water flows from the eye here. It comes into the inlet point here and then go through on the blade here, and then it will comes out at point number 2 here. So the relation between point number 1 and point number 2, because the medium here, the fluid is liquid, so we assume it is incompressible. So we could relate the flow here by using the Bernoulli equation. So this is the Bernoulli equation, and then we assume that the pump head of pump is equal to the manometric head. So we have P over rho g, V square over 2g, Z, and head of pump. So we replace it with a manometric head, and then we have the parameter for outlet here, P over rho g, V square over 2g, and Z. As I said previously, the diameter of suction and delivery pipe is the same, so the velocity will be constant. So without knowing the value of this velocity, we could cancel off this parameter because the value is the same. And then because we are only focusing on inlet and outlet location here, so it means that the height here can be negligible because it will not affect our calculation. So after we neglect the value of velocity and Z here, we could rearrange this equation and we could calculate the manometric head here by P2 minus P1 over rho g, and then we substitute with the value we could get, it is equal to 142.7 meters. Please make sure that in your calculation you are using the SI unit, so means you need to expand the kilopascal. So the kilos will give you 1000 times here, so please be careful in your calculation. The second question, we need to calculate the manometric efficiency. So first, we need to write what is the equation for manometric efficiency. So the equation can be written as GHM over V2U2 minus V1U1. So this is the equation to calculate the manometric efficiency. So means that we need to calculate, we need to determine all these parameter first before we could substitute it in this equation. So what is the first step to answer this one? First, you need to draw the velocity very, very well and correct, because there are only two parameters that can be calculated by using a fixed equation. That parameter is U and VF. I will explain later. Now, please focus on the velocity triangle. So, I hope you could draw your velocity triangle. Again, I will explain it here. We start from the absolute velocity. So, we write absolute velocity at inlet V1 here. And then, we draw the component velocity due to the rotational speed. So, we have tangential velocity U1 here, and we have VR1, velocity relative to the shape of blade. And then we add another velocity component that relate with the theoretical velocity. So this is the flow velocity, and this is the whirl velocity. At outlet, we have again, we start with the absolute velocity. So we have V2 here, and then we have component of VR2 relative with the blade angle here and the tangential velocity U2. And then we have the theoretical velocity VF2 here, flow velocity, and the V whirl velocity 2 at here. Please bear in mind that absolute velocity V1 and V2 here is the resultant velocity. So means that both vector here must close loop with the resultant. So we have VR2 here and U2 here. We have VF2 here and VWL2 here. So at the inlet, they give you the same idea. So we have a U2 here, continue with VR1, and we have VWL1 continue with VF1. And then I hope you could locate the blade angle right in its place. So it is here for blade angle at inlet, and it is here at blade angle at the outlet. So you could draw it at here too. So this is the velocity triangle. Make sure you could draw it very well and correct. Then, as I said, there are two parameters that we can calculated by using a fixed equation. So the first parameter is the value of U. So the basic equation is U equal pi dN over 60. And because we have inlet and outlet, so we could write U1 equal pi D1N over 60, and U2 is equal pi D2N over 60. So the unit for U here is meter per second. And the unit for N here is rotation per minute. To get second in our last answer here, so we need to divide by 60. So if you have rotation per second here, please do not divide it with 60 here, because it already in terms of second. So U1 equal pi D1N over 60. We substitute with the value, so we could get U1 is equal 22.8 meter per second, and U2 is equal to 45.6 meters per second. So another parameter that can be calculated by using fixed equation, I already teach this in the previous lesson, is the value of flow velocity. So flow velocity theoretically can be calculated by using the idea of flow rate over area. So if you see pi dB, pi d is the parameter and b is the width of blade. So mean this is the area that water go through. So we multiply with k here, because sometimes the thickness of the blade will influence the area of the flow. So please refer to my previous lesson about this equation. So for VF1, we have K, we have Q over K pi D1 B1, and for VF2, we have Q over K pi D2 B2. So we substitute the value, so we get VF1 is 3.97 meter per second, and we have VF2 0.4 meter per second. Then, so this is the second parameter that we could calculate by using Fick's equation. Then another velocity or another value we need to calculate based on the velocity triangle. For example, how to relate the velocity and the angle here? Because if we have angle, for sure we could use trigonometry to get certain values or to get new parameter, new value. So we know that the angle beta here in at this location. So it also same with the angle at this area. So in this area, it is a triangle here. So we could say that tangent beta is equal to VF divided by this value. So this value is equal to U minus V world 1. So the basic idea is tangent beta is equal to VF over U minus V world. However, normally we need to calculate, we need to define what is the value of V world. So we could say that V world is equal to U minus VF over tangent beta. So for V world 1 here, so it is equal to U1 minus VF1 over tangent 20, tangent B beta 1 here, and we get 11.9 meter per second. And V world 2 is equal to U2 minus VF2 over tangent 30. So the 30 degree here is given in the question, and we get V world 2 is equal 44.9 meter per second. Then we could, based on all the parameters that we get, we could calculate the manometric efficiency. So this is the equation. We substitute with all the value here, we could calculate the manometric efficiency is equal to 0.78, mean the efficiency is 78%. Next, we need to calculate the power required by electric motor if overall efficiency is 78%. To lift water up to 142.7 meter, the minimum power required by the pump is can be calculated by using this equation, rho GQHM, and then we substitute all the values. The Q, the flow rate here is 0.3 meter cube per second, is given in the question. And manometric head is 142.7. We already calculated HM previously, and we could get 419 kilowatt. And then from the question, we know that the mechanical efficiency of the motor supplying power is 78%. So the actual power that the motor needs to generate is, according to the overall efficiency equation, so we have 0.78 equal power out divided by power in. So power in here is the power from the motor. We could also say that the power in here is the power required of the motor. So we rearrange this equation. So we have power required is equal 419 kilowatt divided by 0.78. So we have 538 kilowatt. You may also think like this after you get this answer. You may think like, the motor will give 538 kilowatt. After that, when this power transferred to the impeller, so because the efficiency is 78%, means when it's transferred from the motor to the impeller, 22% is lost on the way. So the 78% from 538 kilowatt is 419 kilowatt. By using 419 kilowatt, if the flow rate is 0.3, so means this pump can live up to 142.7 meters. So I hope you could understand the idea of efficiency in this question.